Hi, welcome to What's Happening. Here are the top five stories. At number five, the Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority on Thursday granted approval for flight operations in Anambra International Cargo Airport. NCAA said it laid the approval for flight operations into the airport over security considerations when the Anambra State Government made a request on October 28, 2021. The Director General NCAA Musa Nuhu said though flights are allowed into the airport effective December 2, 2021, it must be visual flight rules during sunrise to sunset. NCAA also urged the state governments to adhere strictly to safety, security and COVID-19 protocols at the airport at all times. At number 4, at least 233 primary school teachers faced dismissal for presenting fake certificates to the Kaduna State Government. The chairman of the state's Universal Basic Education Board, Tijani Abdullahi, disclosed this at a media briefing in Kaduna, the state capital, on Thursday, adding that there was no going back in the conduct of competency tests for public school teachers in the state. Abdullahi noted that the board will dismiss the 233 teachers, while their files will be forwarded to the Ministry of Justice to initiate prosecution for forgery. At number 3, still on the issue regarding Sylvester Jr., a 12-year-old boy who was allegedly beaten to death by his colleagues for refusing to join a cult. The family, while reacting to the debunked statement by the school management of Dowen College, a viral video has been released on social media which captures the last moments of the deceased boy. The video shows the 12-year-old boy bleeding from his mouth in pain. According to a relative, the deceased mentioned the names of five persons responsible for the pain before he finally gave up the ghost on Tuesday. At number 2, the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission on Thursday re-arraigned former Governor of Ekiti State, Ayodele Fayose, and his company, Spotless Limited, before a federal high court in Lagos. Fayose is re-arraigned before Justice Chukwujekwu Aneke for alleged money laundering and non-declaration of his assets. The trial continues today, December 3rd, as the EFCC will be calling its 12th witness. At number 1, the National Population Commission on Thursday said it would use electronic means for population estimates in security risk areas during the 2022 National Census. Chairman of the Commission, Nasser Issa Kwara, disclosed this in Abuja at a press conference to commence the fieldwork for the second pre-test exercise in preparation for the forthcoming population and housing census. He added the electronic mode would be used to collect data to make the census accurate and free of controversies. Always remember to wash your hands, wear your mask, and stay safe. That's all for now. See you next time on What's Happening.